Hi there! In this video, I will explain the audio settings of the Sony HXR NX80. On the XLR unit of the camera, you will find the audio settings panel. Using these switches, you can change the audio settings of the camera, both for the set noise mic and the hand or pin mic. You do not have to know all the ins and outs of the audio settings panel to record audio like a pro. Just check if the settings are identical to the picture provided on the camera and you're ready to go. But hold on, if you want to know what all these audio settings mean, just watch the rest of this video. This way, you will have even more control of your audio settings, in every situation. As you can see, the set noise mic is connected to input 2. You can connect your hand mic or pin mic to input 1. Now, let's take a look at the audio settings panel. The first switch is the recording channel select switch. You can choose between channel 1 or channel 1 and 2. Channel 1 and 2 means that only the external microphone will record, which is plugged into input 1. Of course, you also want to record your set noise. That's why we would advise using the channel 1 setting. Since the channel 1 setting means you record both your hand or pin mic and your external microphone. I know this sounds very confusing, because logically you would think it would be the complete opposite, but that's just the way it is. Next, we have two identical sets of switches. These switches allow you to adjust the audio settings for input 1 and input 2. The bottom left switch allows you to pick between auto mode and manual mode. Manual mode allows you to determine the audio levels recorded by the microphone yourself, using the wheel next to the switch. When you select auto mode, the camera does this for you. The camera's auto mode works perfectly. It prevents you from recording audio that peaks either too high or too low, which can and will ruin your recordings. Our default mode is auto mode, but if you're an experienced filmer, the manual mode gives you the opportunity to film sounds at a really high or really low volume. On screen, you can see what the audio level is. Make sure the bars don't peek into the red. The switch on the top left allows you to adjust the sensitivity of your connected microphones, adding 10 dB or 20 dB. Be careful though, because adding dBs will also increase the amount of white noise captured by the microphone. Using the switch on the top right, you can choose between three options: line, mic, and mic plus 48 volts. Line is used when you want to attach your camera to a mixing console. Instead of recording audio with a microphone, you record the audio from the mixing console. This can be useful when you want to film an event and the speaker is already using a microphone for the audience. Mic is used when you want to record a regular microphone. The last option, mic plus 48 volt, which is also called phantom power, means that a small amount of DC electric power is transmitted to the microphone. Feel free to work with all audio devices you like, but the microphones we use need this power supply, so make sure you select mic plus 48 volts. Alright, two remaining switches left. These switches are used to filter out low frequencies from your audio recordings. When using certain types of microphones that record too much low frequency sounds, this option might be useful. Our mics don't have this problem though. And more importantly, while working with us, you always have the editor taking care of your sound design. This means there's no need to use this feature at all. Record audio any way you want. But if you want to be ready at any time, we strongly advise you to use our preferred settings as indicated on the sticker. As you can see, it's easy as 1, 2, 3. Bye!